Kampala, where the Ministry of Health has recalled COVID-19 vaccines from all districts that are yet to utilize them, as demand for the same continues to rise across Kampala and metropolitan areas. The Director of Health Services, Dr. Henry Mwebesa, says due to the increasing number of COVID-19 cases, a number of people in Kampala metropolitan area are increasingly in need of vaccination, thus the need to recall these vaccines from where they are not being used. Let's have the details in the following report.
Vaccines are due to expire on 10th July, as I have already told you, 10th July 2021. To avoid such a catastrophe, it's extremely important that we withdraw these vaccines and use them in the districts which need them and which are ready to replace them, which are calling us every day wanting more vaccines.
The recent wave of COVID-19 infections continues to send health officials and the general public in panic mode. Many who had formerly shunned the COVID-19 vaccination are now demanding for it. At the Ministry of Health head offices in Kampala, hundreds of people, seemingly unbothered by the social distancing rule, braved the scorching sun as they lined up to receive the COVID-19 vaccines. The Ministry of Health's Director General of Health Services, Dr. Henry Mwebesa, says the demand for vaccines in the Kampala metropolitan is already overwhelming.
In consultation with the scientific advisory committee and the vaccine advisory committee, resolve that vaccines be withdrawn from the poorly performing districts to avoid wastage and also expire, and that the exercise should commence 27th May, which is today. And this communication has been sent to the chief administrative officers, the chairpersons, five president district commissioners, and our DHOs, alerting them that starting today, national medical stores will be collecting the vaccines that they have failed to utilize, because we have districts which are yearning for these vaccines and we want to use them before they expire.
The AstraZeneca vaccines, which Uganda received in early March, are due to expire in July this year. The Ministry of Health warned all those districts that are not utilizing the vaccines that should they expire, all concerned leaders will be penalized.
There's no point keeping vaccines in District A when District B is very busy looking for vaccines for use. A district that demonstrates commitment to replace the doses in their facilities with evidence of good progress may be considered to retain some vaccine vials, and this will be determined by the technical teams that come. Take note that there will be penalties for those that waste vaccines or allow vaccines in their possession to expire, yet are very expensive life-saving vaccines. The withdrawn vaccines will be the program for vaccination of population in Kampala metropolitan.
The new wave of infections is worryingly targeting younger people between 20 and 39 years.
It's obvious from our statistics that the number of cases and deaths are increasing, as you have seen from above. Our data shows that the most affected group this time, the age group, is 20 to 39 years old. And that during this period, the intensity of severe and critically ill COVID patients is higher than it was in the previous first wave of the pandemic. So in this wave, the severity of the condition is higher.
The Ministry of Health and World Health Organization have revealed that the current wave of COVID-19 infections is increasingly worrying the health systems, since all the variants have all been detected here.
We have the Indian strain, we have the UK strain, we have the South African strain, and we even had the Nigerian strain. So all the strains are here. So which one we have now, we have all of them. But in terms of if a patient is admitted on the ward, we may not do a specific typing to say that Mwes is admitted with COVID, he now has the COVID of India. What we know is you have the COVID and you may be having one of the strains. Of course, the typing to get the exact strain is a more detailed analysis, which is only done at Uganda Virus Research Institute.
The variants globally, the B117 initially identified in UK is reported in 149 countries, and Uganda has reported already 15 cases. The B351, which was initially identified in South Africa, 102 countries has reported, and Uganda has reported 15 cases.
COVID-19 tests done between May 18th and May 26th registered over 44,280 confirmed COVID-19 cases in the country. According to the ministry, 202 of the cases are contacts and alerts, with the majority of 139 from Kampala, 11 from Gulu, 13 from Tororo, and 6 from Mbale, among other districts. 5 of the cases are of truck drivers, and schools are also increasingly becoming a hotspot of COVID-19 infections. This story was compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news in Kampala.
Now, public health experts and other medics at Tambarara Regional Referral Hospital are urging government to consider what they term as a geographical lockdown to allow for the arrest of a likely spread of the COVID-19.